What's up, everyone? We're back with another tutorial in Cubase. Today, I'm going to show you how to do a quick and dirty master. Mastering is the process of finalizing your track after you've mixed it down. And so we're working with this project here, and it's production music, but I'm not going to send it to the library. I'm just going to use it myself on a video that I'm doing today, probably. So here's what we're working with. So pretty standard stuff, just the drum and bass and snare, that type of thing. So in order to master, and this is not a professional mastering tutorial, it is a quick and dirty mastering tutorial, we'll just throw everything in the mix to a mix bus. As you can see, it's all routed here to a mix bus. And we'll take the mix bus and we'll just add a couple of plugins and we'll call it good. So let's open up the E, edit channel settings, because it's easier to do it from there. So you see that we have all this. This should be off because that's part of my mastering process. So I really use three, including tape saturation, so four. If you include tape saturation, it's four plugins. The first thing I'll do is EQ, and that's just slight tone shaping to the mix. So I've cut a few of the lows because there's a lot of lows. So we can listen to it and then take off this, just a tiny boost, 1 dB, 1.5 dB of everything else. So let's listen to the mix and unbypass it. So subtle changes, and in mastering, subtle changes are the name of the game. You don't want to do anything drastic. So let's just close that. That's on. The next thing I'll add is a multiband compressor. And when you're doing quick and dirty mastering, presets are your friend. So we'll just open this up. And I have the R and B master preset on, and you'll notice a big difference when I unbypass this one, because it just tightens everything up a lot. So let's listen to it. And you can see it's slamming these two bands down pretty hard. This one and this one just a little bit. But there's a lot of low range information in this particular mix, so that stands to reason. So the multiband compressor, it's like a wonder tool for mastering. And if you're doing quick and dirty production music, you gotta use it. And then the presets, they work just fine. I mean, you can tweak it to your taste, but I'm just going quick here. The next thing I would do is add some tape saturation. I'll just use that in the channel strip. The Magneto plugin in Cubase sounds really good. It just adds a little bit of grit. So pretty negligible, but it's just, I don't know, it makes me feel better to know that it's in there. And then the final thing, and this is one of the most important tools in mastering, is your maximizer. And I have it here at the bottom channel because Cubase gives you 8 inserts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These first 6 are pre-fader. This last one is post-fader. So I know that I can control my output gain if I put it in one of the last 2 slots. So I just put it in the last slot. And so looking here at the maximizer, this is the new maximizer, but I'm using classic, not modern. And I have it set to 30%. This is where you can seriously overcook your mix if you dial this up way too much. But I listen to it, and for what I'm going to be using it for, 30 works. I have my output set at negative 2 dB, so I know that the entire mix won't go over negative 2 dB, but it'll be pretty loud, and it'll stick around that level. And you want your mixes to be loud. I mean, right? That's the whole point. So let's listen to this, and then we'll unbypass this. There's a big difference there, and for production music like this, just making it loud and fat in your face is cool. So those are my 4 quick and dirty steps to doing a very fast master. Just a little bit of EQ, some multiband compression, a little bit of tape saturation, and that's really more of a stylistic choice. And then finally a maximizer to get the loudness that you want. And that is all that I do when I'm doing something fast and I just want it to be ready to be put into a video or even sent off to a production library. I'll just do something like this. And that's my quick and dirty mastering process. I may take a little more time if I'm doing a more serious project, but this is sort of the template, even if I'm doing it more seriously. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, or you have other tips on mastering a Cubase, be sure to leave a comment. And I'll be trying to do these Cubase tutorials every Monday. So if you have any suggestions on things that I should do, just leave a comment as well. Thanks for watching, everyone, and have a good day. Bye.